biological terror you've constructed. The ability to destroy a planet is insignificant next to the power of the Force.
Well, so far things aren't entirely broken. Things are kind of working. What's up, everybody? I'm JD Blay. How you doing? I haven't done one of these music streams in a very long time, other than the little test thing I did with Dini, so it feels kind of good to get back to it. The only downside, I feel like, is, like, no one knows that I do this anymore, so there's probably, like, no one that's even going to get notified that I'm doing this. But, it's important to get back to it. I need some water. I should have at least messaged Darth and let him know I was going to do this. He'd probably be upset that I didn't tell him, but I'm sure it won't bother him too much. We're gonna play some songs. We're going to have some fun. We're going to do a whole bunch of stuff. I'm just kind of flying by the seat of my pants today. I think this is from like a Simpsons game. I'm gonna have to review the stream and see how loud the chat music is, because it may need to come down a little bit, but I can review the stream and do that. I'm getting the old recording going. Boom, boom, boom. So I made a lot of big changes to the stream. It won't seem like it, but like back end wise, I did a whole bunch of stuff that's gonna let me move forward now in a way that I hope works. It just, you know, took like 6 months to re-rig everything, or at least took me six months to have the motivation to re-rig everything. So, but we'll feel it out. We'll see how it goes. I don't know what all I'm going to play, because I don't know what all works. There's going to be all kinds of stuff that doesn't work, so that'll be kind of fun to suss out what works and what doesn't. But we'll play some covers. We'll play some original tunes. We're just going to do everything. We're going to have fun. I think I'm going to play another original tune. I'll just do this one instrumental because it's fun. Also, like, my guitar playing is probably total shit, so we'll see just how bad things go. This next song, it's an old Dusks Embrace tune, which I totally... Ooh, I need to add that. I just had an idea of something I need to... a little safety I need to add to the hazer, because the hazer's running right now, and I need to add something at the beginning of every song to turn that hazer off. Actually, I think I have something that has the hazer run at the beginning of every song, so it's probably safe to just go ahead and jump. Let's test it. Let's see what's the worst thing that happens. The worst thing that happens is everything breaks. We'll be right back. man, I'm not even doing vocals in those old metal songs. Wear me out a bit. I'm an old, tired man. I can't keep up with that shit anymore. Whew. But I'm feeling the itch to get back to this. I've got a record coming out here in 2 weeks that I'm really excited about. Well, like 2.5 weeks. So, you know, I'm starting to work on making videos and doing things to promo that and trying to be, you know, a good streamer slash musician and actually do stuff. It's a little different than my normal stuff. It's all like a modular synth for the most part, as well as like some DOS type synth, but it's a little bit different. It's not anything I'll play live because it's not really performed music in any way, but it's still cool to get it out there. I'm excited to kind of try something new, have some fun. I think people will dig it. It's going to be up on like Spotify and Apple and blah, blah, blah. Here in like 2 weeks. So I'll be on Twitch probably a lot during that time, or in the lead up, promoing that a little bit. Let's play a cover or two. So one of the big things I'm changing is my old system had it so that like I had kind of a different way that I did things if I had other people here versus if I was going by myself. And I'm streamlining that so that the setup is the exact same and like what needs to happen is the exact same whether I'm here by myself or have other people. And I think that's gonna make it a lot easier to keep things consistently working, because if the stream operates the same way every single time I do it, it's a lot easier to maintain than having like multiple pathways that can get a little bit away from me at times. One of my favorite Opeth. Like, it's such a simple idea. It's just this kind of walking down chromatic minor major thing. For whatever reason, it's always been one of my favorite things. There's the... Oh, that's awful. I took her by the hand to say all fate forever has been washed away. It's just like such a good melody that follows those chords, and it's always been kind of one of my favorite things to play. Or I don't know. I just thought it was a really creative idea. I don't listen to Opeth a lot anymore like I used to, but I still feel like Michael has some really good ideas. Songs can be a little all over the place from time to time, but in general, I feel like it's pretty solid. I think I need to zoom this in later so I can see a little better, but I'm hoping that this really helps, like, if I have one pathway for everything to be, hoping it makes life a little easier. I've also been spending a lot of time on color. I said that before, and the color was shit. So this time I, like, really spent some time on color, and I think it's gotten better, I hope. I think I need to diffuse this light behind me, though, like this solid beam. I think that could diffuse a bit and look a little bit better and be a better backlight. So I might work on diffusing that next. I diffused some of my front lights and that. I don't know if you can see. Let's see here if we can. Where is go home? Go home. Let's go to cut bus. If I just go to the drum, should be this one, right? This camera. There we go. You should. No, it's not quite high enough. You can't quite see the lights. What's up, Moosey? How you doing? So we'll just cut back to the main camera. But I'm slowly trying to get all this stuff balanced. It's just gets away from me. It's a lot to keep in track. Like, I got a new lens on this camera, though, and I'm really enjoying what it's doing for the main camera. Oh, Moosey. I'm tired. I'm having fun doing music again, though. Let's play some Millencolin. I don't have the requester app stuff up and working again. There's still a whole lot of stuff in the stream that's not operational yet like it used to be, but I am kind of ready to get that back up and running. I'm feeling motivated. It's going to happen, I think. Do what I gotta do. Yeah, it's gonna happen. I've been grinding away at the stream, so I think it's getting better. It's just, you know, time and money. Always time and money.
Tell us where you're from. What
guitar just will not stay in tune. Les Pauls are just notorious for having tuning problems. All right, we're back. Yeah, I don't know what's up with the drums. Like, I'm trying to run them over the network the way they're supposed to, and they're just dropping out on me like crazy. So let me try and lower the buffer a bit and see if I can get it to behave a little better. Am I going to be able to do this visually from here? I think I can. Right about there. Let's see here. Can I, like... nope, I got a hard wall there. I can't do it. Have I been playing it lately? No, not really. I only usually do the drums this way when Deanie's here. And, like, I never get it working quite right. So I kind of decided that, like, oh, shit, that's not going to work. Hold on, I got to go to the main computer. Maybe if I do this, it won't look so bad when I go fix it. Oh, I see what you're saying. You mean, like, Les Paul's... Yeah, also, like, I think that this is probably a multiple, like, a double-sided problem, because not only have I not played this guitar super often, but it's been, like, ridiculously cold here this, like, last 24 hours. It's been in, like, the 20 degrees, which is way colder than it normally gets. So I think that probably has something to do with it as well. Also need to remember to switch the camera back. It's so crazy what a difference a good lens makes. Like, I need more good lenses. But yeah, like, Les Pauls, like, I think they're worse than most guitars as far as staying in tune. Like, all guitars kind of have their problems, but Les Pauls definitely seem to be kind of in the worst category, I think. I'm playing an original tune. But I'm deciding that I just need to use all this stuff the way it's going to be, because I've had all of these, like, backup plans forever. But the problem is, if I stay on them, I never fix the problems. I need to just, like, stream and, you know, get caught with my pants down, and that'll force me to actually fix the problems. So how's your day going, Moosey? Hopefully you're doing well. Perfection through embarrassment. Exactly. I think that's the way. Because, like, I'm always trying to get it just right before I stream, but it's inevitably, it's too much. It's always going to be broken some way, somehow. So I may as well just get on here, look like an asshole, find the problems, and then I can go back. Like, it's way easier to go back through the records and find where the problems were. Because if I just try and, like, hunt them all down, I feel like it's just, I'm kind of chasing it forever and never getting anywhere. But if I have the records, I have, like, you know, very specific problems that I can tackle. Like, this was wrong, and this was wrong. And yeah, like, also less barrier to get going. Yeah, exactly. And, like, you know, it's a Twitch stream. There's probably, like, 3 people watching, so who cares if it's shit? It's probably better than I normally do anyways. I don't play this guitar as much anymore. I like it. I don't know why I never play it. But yeah, I think if I just try and, like, stream every couple days and track down the problems, I'll eventually, slowly, get less and less of them happening in the stream. I'll probably never get it perfect. It'll probably always have bugs. Like, when I'm working up at Nike, this is the kind of show that we'd have, like, 6 people or 7 people on crew to run. So I don't feel bad that it's buggy. And also, like, working at Nike has changed my, it's changed my expectations of this a little bit, I think, because, like, you know, I went up there and they're, like, a multi-billion-dollar company, and we have all the same tech problems up there. It's all the same bullshit. There's, like, 6 people trying to figure out what's wrong, what's broken, why. So I feel a little bit less bad that I struggle with it here at home, I guess. Maybe I shouldn't feel better about it because of that, but I definitely do. Like, if they can't solve these problems with billions of dollars, I can't be so mad when I can't keep up with it on my own, I guess. What types of shows does Nike stream? What I do is, like, really boring, just meetings. It's just team meetings. I think I did one. They have like their sneakers app, which is like a like the Hazer, the sneakers app, where they did a show about like upcoming shoes and stuff. That's like the only customer, like consumer facing show I've done so far. Otherwise it's all internal stuff, nothing super exciting. On occasion when we're up in the studio we do higher visual production stuff, but it's definitely not like it's not what we're doing every day. Every day is more just like a couple PTZ cameras and follow the person talking. But on occasion, you know, up in the studio, we've got like a big LED wall that we use for a background, and you get to have a little bit more fun with that, and that's cool. It's like, it teaches me all the gear that I want to buy for this. All right, let's play an original tune. I'm going to play a song called With Cleansing Flames. Let's see if I can, is this a new job? I've been doing it for 4 months, I think. I don't technically work for them. I'm working freelance, so like... it's kind of like I just get emails like, hey, can you work today? Sure. So it's not like a job in the same in the sense. It's just freelance. But I'm pretty much solely working freelance now, which is kind of cool. It gives me some freedom in a lot of ways. And, you know, feeds the addiction to buy more and more gear. And my felt's falling apart on my SM7. That's a bummer. Is the switch to freelance about as new? Yeah, I went freelance to do the Nike gig because I was working at a video production company and they did like full-time only, so I had to go freelance in order to do the Nike stuff. But it's been a good switch. I still work at the old company freelance. That's what I was doing the last 2 weeks, so in some ways nothing changed, but seemed busier. That's what you thought with my last job? No, it was surprisingly like an actual employment job, which is weird for the video production industry. Like, almost all work in that field is freelance, so. You work for your old job a bit too? Yeah, that seems to be kind of how freelance goes. It's like you end up kind of working everywhere all the time, doing everything. It's funny how that works. All right, here we go. This is With Cleansing Flames. Let's see if I can remember how to play this. I'm not entirely sure that I do. Time. So What's up, Darth? Yeah, finally getting back in the saddle. I'm trying to get kind of back in the groove of things. I spent the last 3 months kind of fixing some major flaws with the way all the automation worked. It took me a little bit of time to fix that. But now that it's kind of up and operational again and I don't have the major breaks that were there, I feel a lot better getting back to it. Also, I was going to say, Moosey, when did you start doing freelance stuff? I don't know if you'd mentioned that to me before or not, but... or are you still doing that? Because, I don't know, for me, like, I don't think I'll ever go back to employment if I can avoid it. I like the freelance gig quite a bit. It seems to work well for me. Oh, boy. 2006? Wow, so it's been quite some time. Have you been doing freelance ever since then, or has it been kind of like an off and on thing for you? Because I know a lot of people that do it kind of off and on. They'll do it some, and then, yeah, I get that. It seems like it's like either I'm like so busy that I don't have a moment to breathe, or I have a whole week off or a whole 2 weeks off. It's never like smooth. It's always just like all or nothing every time. So when are you going to get back down here and play some music with me again, Darth? I'm ready. Well, that's not entirely true. I'm trying to like compartmentalize in my brain that I just need to go through and do like one song at a time and get one song totally finished and working and ready to move on from. Everything you do feels significant. Yeah, I do like that too. Like it just feels like everything kind of matters a bit more because it's not just like you're just... showing up, punching the clock, and going home. You actually have to care to make sure you get your paycheck. Although with Nike being as corporate as it is, it could be a little punch the clock, but the other jobs that I do, they're not quite as bad for that, but it's nice to have something that feels, you know, like you can put some real effort into it and care about how it comes out. I do still love the tone of this guitar. It's just got such a nice, like, body to it. If I do, like, some crunch. I gotta rebalance all of these. Like, once I got these headphones, they're, like, open back headphones instead of closed, they started telling me a lot about how bad my mixes were. So... I need to go back and fix a lot of this stuff, but at least I feel like I can hear it now. And that's nice. That does make a difference. Oh, I gotta remember that I need to change the drums, and we'll see if upping the buffer fixed that problem. I'm hoping the answer is yes. Ugh, man. I forgot how, like, sweaty and warm it gets, but at least, like, for a while I had this problem, because, like, I had a controller for my hazer that had it going off on a timer. That controller died. I think the port died because I got a new controller and it didn't fix it. So I had this, like, I'm using DMX to control it. And the way I was doing it at first was not working very well, and it kept getting stuck on. And then it would just, like, blast haze for 20 minutes and I'd be dying. So I've got, like, a new automation scheme that kind of fixes that. But it took a while to figure that out. I'm glad that it's actually working. I'm going to play some Blondie. This is Heart of Glass by Blondie. And I'm sure there's still drum stuff I got to fix on this, but it'll be okay.
Thank you.
Well, at least all the transitions are working. I also got this new like chat layout going on. I kind of adapted my video game layout to be for this because I really like the way it came out. So I'm feeling like I'm gonna stick with it for the year. I have another one that I was working on. I don't know if I like it as much. It's this one here. It's kind of like a more clean, modern looking type thing. Also, I hope that didn't totally blow my chat out. I don't think it should have. And I don't know why the chat's not working on this one. I've got to figure that out too. But I think I like this one better for now. Yeah, it did wipe my chat. That kind of sucks. Or the chat box just hasn't been working this whole time. That's also possible. For whatever reason, the chat box seems to be broken a lot of times, and I'm not entirely sure why. I haven't figured it out. Like, I test it before the stream and it works, and then I go live and it's broken. So I haven't quite figured that one out yet. Because it shouldn't be resetting, but maybe it is resetting whenever the scene doesn't stay active, but I want the chat to stay, so I'll test that later. It's still, it's a weird problem, but I'll figure it out. It's just a problem. One of many. Oh, what can I play with this guitar? Let's play some Ramones. I haven't done like some punk stuff in a while. I'm kinda feeling in like the aggressive mood. I might even do some In Flames later. We'll see. I don't know if Darth is still around or not, but if he is, maybe we'll do some In Flames. Talking about the Ramones at work today, and now I'm all like in the mood to play a Ramones song. Although I don't feel like I sing it particularly well, so I always kind of avoid playing it. Say what? I was saying if you're still around, I might play some In Flames later. I don't know. We'll have to see. And hey, the chat box is working. It's just resetting when I leave the scene, so I need to figure that out. Figure out why is it broken. Actually, you know what? We'll do one for you, Darth. We'll see how this goes. It can only go so poorly, right? So, I mean, what the hell? This next song is for Darth because he loves this terrible shit that I used to play that's not good. But I will get it dialed in. A lot of these old songs, I need to finish them up and get good mixes on them and write some more quality lights. I think one of the biggest problems I've had is like, I built this stream and that got me a job in video production. And then getting a job in video production taught me so much that I wanted to bring to the stream that I just haven't been able to implement all of it. Now I feel like none of it's good enough. So that's been kind of a thing. I've been keep trying to upgrade shit, and it's getting away from me. But here we go. This one's for you, Darth. You'll recognize it. You'll recognize the old bullshit, and we'll see how well this is gonna trash my voice. I'm sure of it. But we'll give it a try. What's the worst that happens?
Watch with your
I have no idea. It is one of my favorites from that era. I will say, like, from that era, it's not so bad. I don't love that the chat keeps resetting itself. OBS did, like, a huge update, and it keeps fucking breaking. Like, every time I open OBS, it wants to reconnect as if I've never connected OBS before. It's really annoying, and I can't quite figure out why it's doing it. But I feel like there's certain settings that it's, like, resetting every single time I do that. And what the hell? It didn't reset properly. Shit's broken. Shit's broken. It's weird, like, sometimes, on rare occasions, it'll just decide to not hit the marker. I still haven't figured out why. It's like, it's super inconsistent whether that happens or not, and I can't quite figure out what causes it to miss sometimes. While I'm here, I'm just gonna fix that chat thing real fast, because I think I know what to do. It's still super weird that it reset it. Yeah, it like defaulted back to shut down source when not active, and I think that breaks it, so I don't know why it does it. It's also, I'm still not used to this whole, like, it's got like boxes around your name whenever you chat Darth because you're a mod. I haven't quite figured that one out yet. I don't know if I like it or not. I might turn that off. Oof, boy, that really trashed my voice. Oops, didn't mean to do that. Let's play something else. I'm not going to do like a crazy long stream, but probably another half hour or so. We'll see how I hold up. Oh boy, that really wiped me out. I'm tired now. I don't do those death metal vocals often anymore, and I need to, like, get back in the practice of doing them, because otherwise I'm going to lose it forever. Like, if I don't keep that muscle going, it's definitely going to go away. I feel like that was better than it has been sometimes, streaming, but it definitely wasn't good yet. It's still far from being good. Like, I feel like it was at its best either on the Twilight record or on the In Dead Tones, or not In Dead Tones, but Idols. I think Idols is where it was at its best. And then I just fucking quit doing it and lost it completely. That little melody always makes me think of Bedknobs and Broomsticks for some reason. So I need to do the shameless plug thing, like I was saying earlier, here in 2 weeks. Well, 2 weeks from Friday, I've got a new record releasing called The Ocean Beneath. It's like a modular synth record, so it's a little bit different than my normal music. It's more like, you know, throw on to fall asleep to kind of music. It's just mood, vibey kind of thing. It's not like songs. It's a little bit different for me, and it was fun to work on. So that's going to be coming out on like Spotify and everything here in about 2 weeks. And I'll be popping on to stream some more music in the meantime, so I'll keep talking about it and bore everyone to death with talking about it. But it'll be good. It'll be fun. I'm looking forward to it. Feels good to finally be releasing some music again after like 6 years. Six and a half years. Ugh, gross. I can't believe it's been that long since I put anything out. Like, I had a record ready to go, and then I burnt out and didn't do it, and then I started the stream thing and didn't focus on releasing music for a long time, so it's been a minute. Let's play a couple video game tunes. We're gonna play the Mystic Quest battle theme. Boy, I gotta get back up on playing a lot of these songs. I'm wildly out of shape on all of my musical chops. We'll be right back. Boy, I totally forgot to change the drum kit. That sounded weird. That is not how that song is supposed to sound. I've got to do this as if Deanie were here, but I'm really struggling to remember to hit the button or to do the thing every time. Just got to get it into my habits. It's still a fun song to play. It's just that soundtrack is so good. Ugh. It's tough too, because I keep wanting to like move on to new material and write stuff, but this stuff is all still so unfinished, and I really need to like gotta push them buttons. Yeah, exactly right. Like, I really need to, like, finalize some of this stuff so I can walk away from it and be done. It's just been so hard because I've learned so much the last 2 years. So, like, what I thought was good 2 years ago when I built all this stuff, I don't think is good anymore. But that may always be the case. That may just be a state of reality that I have to live with. I don't know. It's a cool melody. But yeah, it's one of those things that, like, I don't know if I'll ever perfectly be happy with how the stream is, but I've got to not let that stop me from actually streaming. But you need to grab the bass and do some practice so that next time you're here, we can do some streamers. That'd be fun. The only thing I'm worried about is I don't know that this lens that I'm using is going to work for when you're here, so I may need to get a different lens instead of this 24 to 70. I need like a 16 to 70, but I don't know if I want to spend another whatever for a lens, but I kind of do. We'll see. I'll think about it. It's a maybe, but if I did, then I could use that lens over here. You will do that? Good, 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 because it would be fun to play some music. And if we suck, we suck. Who cares? Let's have fun. When are you down next? Probably not this weekend, but next. Or is it this weekend? If it's this weekend, we're doing some music. Even if you don't remember how to play a single damn song, you can just play them all wrong, and it's fine. I don't care anymore. I just need to stream. It's good. It's good. Hey, we do suck at everything else we do. You're not wrong. I still need to finish Elden Ring too. Ugh, I'm not looking forward to that one. Let's keep these video games rolling. Let's do... Also, I want to stream Mario 64. That's one thing I want to do soon. I forgot how to play it. We'll be right back. always a fun one. I still need to get the videos in for that. I've been talking about that for 2 years, and I've been lazy about it for 2 years. Such a good track. I don't know what this is from, though. Some NES game, for sure, but I don't know what one. Let's see if we can look it up. I want to know what this is. If anybody in chat knows, say it before I find out. It's from from Gradius. Okay, it's from Gradius 2. Gradius 2 was such a good game. Hard as fucking shit, but it was fun. Hollow Knight is going through a major overhaul, so it's probably going to be a while till I play Hollow Knight, because we're doing a full revamp of that track, and it's going to be oh so much better. But, yeah, we'll leave that one alone for now. We still need to get a item share rando going with Turtle. I really want to do that. It'd be fun. Let's see here. What do I want to play? Let's do Sweetness. I'm gonna do that. And real quick, before I even switch guitars out, I'm going to remember to change the drum kit. I've changed my mind. I need to bring the WAV files back, and because I was just like, I'm just gonna throw them all in there and it'll force me to do it, but it's just gonna take too much time. I need to put the WAV files back, and I need to do them one at a time. Do I? I don't know. If I leave it like this, maybe it'll motivate me to actually do it. Something to be said for if I don't work on it, it's going to be broken. So I think that's what I'm going with. I'm going to force myself by leaving it kind of broken, and I have to get in here and fix it. I got a record ready to release that gives me a buffer feeling that I can kind of relax a little bit, work on the stream for a month or so, and then I'll dig back into the JD Blay record, because I do still need to finish those four or five songs. They're about ready to go. I do love the tone of this guitar. I don't remember it. That riff go. Yeah, that sounds terrible on this guitar. Maybe I just single coil it. Something like that. You've been enjoying the playlist? That's good. I've been listening to it a lot too, and it's been a lot of fun to just kind of have all the music at my fingertips. I just like kind of throwing it in random and seeing what happens. Have you found, you haven't heard that Porcupine Tree song in a while? Yeah, I think that record's in the playlist. Isn't Deadwing in there? I don't think I've really run into anything from it yet, though. I heard something from Fear of a Blank Planet, but I don't think I've heard anything from Deadwing yet. I mean, it's got over 4,000 songs in it, so I guess I still need to add Hammerfall. I haven't done that. You were surprised running into a gospel song? Which, was it like Hank Williams? It was probably like a Hank Williams song or something. For some reason, I have like 10 songs of Hank Williams, and I hear one every day. I don't understand it. Still haven't run. I think I've heard like, it was Williams, yeah. I think I've had like one Johnny Horton song come up, but that's it. That's all I've had, which I wish more of that would come up, but I don't quite understand it. All right, here we go. Let's see how this one sounds. This is Sweetness by Jimmy World. I can find it in the list. There it is. I found it. Here we go. God wills it.
If you're listening, whoa.
Instinct? I think that was Killer Instinct. I missed it, but I think it was Killer Instinct. Yeah, the drums still keep dropping out, and I gotta figure out what's wrong with that. I think I need to just get in the habit of rebooting that computer, and I think I'm gonna need to end up separating the keyboards from the drums and give them both their own computer, and I just don't want to do it. I just don't want to do it. It's gonna be such a headache. To be honest, it's just, ugh. How many computers am I using to stream? I'm gonna have to think through that real fast. So, there's the main audio computer. There's the camera computer, which then goes to the overlay computer, which goes to OBS, which goes to record. There is the lighting computer. I have a laptop for remote control. I have an iPad for being able to remote control OBS and chat. There's a computer that runs the streaming music, like the backing music we're listening to. And if Deanie's here, he has another computer that runs his deal. So what is that? There's audio, camera, overlay, OBS, record, laptop, iPad, Camsys. And normally I have like a laptop that I use for monitoring stream as well. So it's like 9 or 10 computers. It's a lot. Yeah, it's a big part of the reason why I end up not streaming more often than I should is just because I built this stupid thing and it's broken half the time. Like, it's just, it's too much. It's stupid. It's so many computers. There's bound to be something wrong. But like, so, you know, I have like one computer that does nothing but deal with like this, like being able to cut cameras. That's a computer because it's so many cameras, it needs a dedicated computer. There's another computer that just runs like the overlays, like doing the vintage effects and stuff. OBS does like the color correction and all the chat layout stuff. I have to have a dedicated computer to run all this stupid lighting stuff in the grid, and it's fucking dumb. It is probably why something is always broken. It's a lot of computers. I have to remote control all of them. It's stupid. And I think eventually it's going to be like 6 different MIDI interfaces to keep them all connected. And because I think it's already, what, 1, 2, 3, 4? Yeah, so I need to get 2 more. It's a mess. It's why things are always a little bit broken. It's a bad choice. I can accept that it's a bad choice. The real bummer, so it's both actually. So with video, like the cameras all come into capture cards, and then I have like an external card that sends that to another capture card into the computer where it just gets a composite of all the cameras to do effects. Then that sends out to OBS, and that sends out to the record computer. And then MIDI sends to all of the computers so that like when I press this button to do this, that's sending a MIDI signal from my audio computer over a virtual MIDI port to the camera computer to tell it to cut cameras. And same with like the lighting, it's all MIDI being sent from one computer to another. The OBS changes are all MIDI from one computer to another. So like capture cards are how the video signals get around, and MIDI is how all of the scene changes and lighting triggers and guitar changes and stuff happen. So it's kind of a mix of both. Hopefully that was instructions. Yeah. One of these days I'm going to like create a series of videos that just like details how it works. And actually I've been getting ready. I think here in the next month or two, I might like tear the entire studio apart and rewire it in a more sensible and more flexible way. And I might do like a series of vlogs on like rebuilding the studio and kind of explaining how it all works. Maybe. I don't know. I don't know if anybody would give two shits about that, but I might do it just so I have something fun to do while I'm rebuilding, because it's going to take a month. But it would be fun. You tear your 1 to 3 computer desk apart to redo wires? Yeah, and I'm like so due for that. It's just like this huge undertaking of trying to remember how they're all interconnected. So like, I just need to wrap my head around it. And also I'd be like making some major changes to the way things are wired because I need to. Like, one of the big things right now is all of the lights are daisy chained. They're all on one DMX universe, which I'll keep them on one universe, but I would love to split out the power and the DMX so that like banks are on different power lines so that I could turn certain things on without like, how do I half my computers while doing it? Yeah, I wish I could get rid of them. I've actually been thinking about adding two, but I came up with a scheme last night with the automation in OBS that made it so I didn't have to add another computer. So I was pretty excited about that. Like, I thought for changing some stuff I was gonna do about color correcting that I was gonna need to add a whole nother computer, and I'm glad that I came up with a different solution. Because I really don't want another computer. It's just... so often I run into problems that can't be solved without another computer. That's fun. C major, it's like, it's a boring key, but you can have some fun with it. Oh, that reset does not work very well, does it? Do I use all of those computers when I game stream too? Unfortunately, yes. I wish the answer was no because it would make my life a lot easier, but unfortunately because of the way the video signal flows, I have no choice but to use all of the computers when I video game stream too, and it's stupid because I really only need two or three computers to stream video games. Like, a stream computer, a game computer, and a lighting computer is all I need to do that, but it would require rewiring everything every single time. And the real frustrating thing is because since I master the music before it heads over, the delay times are different for audio stream and game stream, so I have to like constantly measure the delay times and reset them. And for whatever reason, even if I never change anything, it seems like the delay times change. Like, I have to measure it and readjust it once a month for no reason, and I find that very frustrating. But it's made me think that one of these days I would love to have a separate room and build like a smaller game stream setup so that I don't have to readjust things. It's just I don't want to buy, you know, another camera and all the bullshit that goes with that. And I know it seems like you would just say, like, well, just move one of the cameras you have. And I do that sometimes, but it also seems like every time I move and reset things, I break things and then I spend a week getting it all working again. So there's kind of just no good answer. It's just... I haven't figured out a good way to do all this yet. I'm still very much so in the building and figuring out process. 4 years in, I'm still trying to figure out the basics. I still need to get like a good light on the roads too. I feel like it's dark.
I never play it. Oh, it's out of tune.
I wish I played it more, but oof. There's a thing called jungle fever with medicine. When a person is prescribed so many medications, it makes them take on a new sickness. Yeah, I mean, you're 100% not wrong, Moosey, but I like the control. I want it to do what I want it to do, and I hate when I run into limitations. It really bothers me. And so I push into the wall and it makes me cry and I burn out for 3 months and then I come back and everything's broken and I do a stream like this. That's kind of my repetitive cycle. It's what I do. I have this brilliant idea that ruins my life and then I wonder why I'm so stressed. And I love it. As stupid as it is, I love this song. All right, let's play a song. This is Dire Dire Docks from Mario 64. That's not the right song. I hit the wrong button. I really appreciate that, Moosey. That's nice of you to say. Like, in my mind, there's so much more I want. Like, I know it's gonna sound silly, but I probably spent like 3 hours the other day just white balancing the colors of my lights and my cameras so that like skin tones looked correct. Cause before I was all like kind of super reddish and lobstery, and I really wanted that just like the right skin tones. It's one of those things too, when I'm using like this camera and lens, I can get it right, but now I've got to like figure it out with all the other ones and with each of their positions. It's a huge pain, but I do appreciate that. Long story short, it's nice of you to say that. It means a lot to me. I want this stream to be like as high production value as I can possibly make it on my own, even if that's, you know, not always as much as I would like it to be. But I will say, by the end of this year, by the end of 2023, there's going to be some big overhauls and things are going to be looking a lot better. Like, the way this camera looks right now is my new, like, bar. Yeah, and I do know Scene of Action. He was one that I found pretty early on, and I really liked his stream, and I stole a good bit of ideas from him. Like, these moving lights on the side that do the thing, I think I totally stole that from Scene of Action. The one thing I don't love about Scene of Action, and this is nothing against him. This is, like, I think he does a great job. He's a little too rock star for me, I might say. You know, like, I don't like putting on the rock show thing. And to me, it's like, even though I want like all the stream to be as produced as possible, I still want it to be kind of low key and still just kind of like chilling, hanging out, talking type thing. I don't want it to be like a separation kind of thing. And I don't know, maybe his stream's not as bad about that as I think. You know, when I go into playing a song, I want it to look and feel like a show. And I'll laugh when I fuck up and stuff. But I want the stream to feel just kind of chill, just kind of fucking off. It's funny. I put my whole life into making it as professional as possible, but I want to get on here and fuck off. It makes no sense. It's a lot more of a show than a conversation. Yeah, I agree with that. And I'd rather kind of, like, you know, when it's in song mode, I kind of like it to be that way a little bit. But even then, I'll fuck off and talk if I can. But I do want it to be more of a, I don't know. I don't like playing a show, being, you know, like having that separation. It's not as fun for me. I'll play like one more, I think. Probably play one more and then I'll probably call it a night. Just trying to think of what I want to play. But I made a lot of decisions that I knew were stupid for streaming going in, like having no real stylistic direction and no plan when I start a stream, just kind of doing whatever the hell. Like, I already know those are things that are not, like, good for progress of a stream, but I enjoy it, so I'd much rather be entertained myself. Oh, I'm sure that there are. There's no way that, like, 4 years into, you know, people being a lot more serious about doing music, that somebody hasn't done something. I'm sure. I think there's two channels I know of. One's like Glostic Willy, and there's another one that's like a band, or maybe that is the one that's a band. It's like three or four dudes, and their production level's really high. I had a buddy, Other Glow, who streamed a lot, and his stream production was really high. And same for After Ever, he was pretty up there too. But I don't think they stream all that much anymore. A lot of us that were kind of there at the same time kind of fell off the map. It's hard to stay on sometimes, you know? When you're trying to have high production value, it wears on you. You just stumble into it, yeah. I get that. The funny thing is like, I feel like a lot of the game streamers that I like are ones that don't have high production value. People like Barbarous King or The Beast. I watch a lot of Grand Pooh Bear, not on Twitch, but on YouTube. I actually watch all of it on YouTube. I don't really watch hardly anything on Twitch. But I gravitate to the people that I think are like the best at their game. I think that's what really is interesting to me, people who seem like they're the best at what they do. It just kind of depends. All right. I don't know if you're still here or not, Darth. Seems like every social media platform kind of screws its creators. Yeah, it really does. And, like, I kind of have this belief, and this is why I don't beat myself up too much when I don't stream music for a while. Like, kind of have this belief that this, like, putting out content every day and kind of always being on is really bad for creativity. It kind of forces you to always have an idea. And some days, I don't want to have an idea. I'd rather do nothing than have a bad idea. So for me, like, I kind of like not making my money from this. This is just what I love to do. Because I don't want to feel like I have to do it, even if I think it's not good or even if I don't want to. You know what I mean? That's just, that's not fun. I only want to do this if I want to be here. And so many content creators anymore, it feels like they're just like making content for content's sake. And I think that really sucks. I'm really bummed out by that. Like, it's probably always been a thing. Maybe. But I'm kind of bummed out. That's the only way to stream. Oh yeah, it totally is. Like, for me, it's the only way I could ever make it work. Otherwise, I'd lose my mind. Otherwise, I'd rather just go do my job because my job is easier and pays better. Have the ambition, but not the reality. Yeah, for sure. And also, like, especially, like, one of the big struggles I've had is, like, to do this kind of stuff. It takes so much money and it takes so much setup time that, like, I can't really stream all the time because I spend so much time in the back end. And I've tried coming up with ways to, like, stream the production process, but that ends up becoming a struggle to stream in and of itself. And then I don't, like, it's weird because then, like, I won't work on production because I should stream it, but it's too stressful to stream it, and it's a mess. It's optional for it to take so much money. You're not wrong there. I can't fight you on that one. I will grant you that I am the author of my own demise. You're not wrong. So since you're still here, Darth, I'm going to play one last song for you. I'm going to get some water. Moosey, it's been super cool of you to come hang out. I'm going to try and be on here and do stuff more often. Some of my short-term plans are do a lot more music streams and maybe build a separate area to do game streams so that it's not a two-hour process to re-rig the studio for gaming. It's a big, like, frame rate conversion process, and I inevitably always forget something and fuck something up. So it'd be nice to have, like, a dedicated gaming space. So that may be in my near future. We'll see. But then again, more money. All right, this is an original song that I'm going to end the song in the night with. This is, You're Totally Cool If I Stream a Lot or a Little. Yeah, and I think, you know, I'm not trying to be a professional Twitch streamer by any means, you know? Like, I've got my day job. It's not so bad. It pays the bills. I just want to make music. What I really want to find is, like, you know, a drummer who can be here consistently and have Darth back on bass, or someone else who can come in and play bass when he's not here. Like, I just want to get musicians in here again because it's so much more fun when I have other people to work with. I just, you know, need to get it all working so that when other people come over, it's not just me crying because everything won't work and we can't stream. Maybe that means pairing back computers, but I don't think that's the answer. Or I should say that's not going to be the answer. It probably is the answer. All right, here we go. This is In Dead Tongues. I'm going to trash my voice. It would be fun to have you down here and play more. Let's do this. Let's play some metal. We'll be right back. Well, thanks all for coming in and hanging out. I think my overarching plan moving forward is start trying to finalize one song at a time. Don't push too hard. Stream even though things are broken and live with it. I think the things that were so broken that I couldn't continue streaming and I would have to end the stream, I think I have fixed all of those problems. One of the biggest ones is I'm still running, like I have two separate lighting systems that are running, and there's like a switchover system that moves between them so that I didn't lose all of my old programming, but I need to go replace all that old programming and get that system phased out. It's just going to take me a year or two to do it because it's a lot. But I think I've worked out all the bugs of switching between those two systems because it was just a real nightmare. I was constantly having the lighting grid bugging out on me. So I think I've solved that, which means streams are a lot more possible. And we're going to do it more. So how warm does all this gear make my room? Pretty fucking warm. Today, you know, it's 20 degrees outside, so it doesn't feel too bad in here. But especially when I stream and the hazer's going and stuff, it gets pretty hot in here. It gets pretty nutty. You know, it can be cold in here at times when I'm just like hanging out, but whenever I'm doing like a full stream, luckily, like, you can't see it, but that over that way, maybe if I do this, it's this camera. So like out that door over there is like a hallway, and there's a server rack out there, and the majority of the computers live outside of the room, and I run cabling into the room. That saves a lot on heat, because if all six of those computers were running in here, I'd be dying. Like, also, I'd be completely out of room. So that saves me a lot of headache. Also, that thing being fairly open lets it vent a little bit. So that kind of saves me a little bit. I need to rig up a button to be able to turn the hazer playback off from here. I have some ideas on how I can do that. Anyway, thank you all for coming. I really appreciate it. It's been fun. I feel good being back. I appreciate you chilling, and we'll do more of this real soon. So take it easy.